everyone. My name is Valerie, and I am the Outreach Coordinator for Future Energy Systems. Welcome back to part two of I Wonder Why There's a Hole in the Sky and Other Questions About the Environment, written by Sean Callery. And let's get right into it. Why is there a hole in the sky? High up in the atmosphere is the ozone layer. It filters out the sun's harmful rays. The ozone layer is damaged by chemicals called chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs for short, which were used in spray cans and fridges. CFCs have made a big hole in the ozone layer over Antarctica. Is the hole there the entire time? No, the hole opens and closes with the seasons. The biggest hole so far was over Antarctica in 2006. There is no hole above the Arctic, but the ozone has become thinner. CFCs have been used less since 1987, and the damage to the ozone layer has slowed. CFCs have been replaced by hydrochlorofluorocarbons, or HCFCs, which are much less damaging, but even trickier to spell. How can water be bad for you? We need fresh water to live, but when chemicals and human waste get into rivers and lakes, water becomes polluted, dirty. This kills around 5 million people a year. That's around 14,000 deaths a day just from dirty water. When is oil like glue? When oil tankers leak, it causes huge damage to the environment, especially to seabirds, seals, and sea otters. The oil sticks to their feathers or skin and makes it hard for them to move or stay warm. In April 2010, an oil drilling rig in the Gulf of Mexico exploded, causing the worst environmental disaster in U.S. history. Many thousands of birds, fish, and sea creatures were killed. Can the air make you choke? Smoke from factories and fumes from engine exhaust pipes send dirt and gas into the air, making it hard to breathe. In some cities, you can see the pollution hanging in the air. This is called smog. In 1952, smog over London, UK killed 12,000 people. The dense fog was called a pea super because it was thick, like pea soup. Why are some animals on the move? Animals sense when the climate changes, and as a result, some are moving to cooler regions. In North America, the red fox is moving into the Arctic and threatening the Arctic fox, which cannot compete with its bigger cousin. Who needs a place to call home? Elephants roam the grasslands of Africa and Asia. Much of this land is being turned into farmland, so the elephants are losing their habitat. This means that elephants could become extinct, die out. Who is a tiger's worst enemy? For a long time, people have hunted tigers for their skins and for their body parts, which are then used in medicines. Hunting tigers is now against the law in most countries, but some people still kill them illegally. Many American pikas, or rock rabbits, are moving to higher land because they like cool temperatures. The warmer climate may make them extinct. The dodo was a flightless bird that lived in Mauritius. It became extinct over 300 years ago when it was hunted to death. What energy never runs out? Energy from water, the wind, or the sun is called renewable energy. Unlike oil, gas, or coal, it will never run out. Also, it does not produce carbon dioxide, so it will not speed up global warming. Scientists are developing technology that extracts clean and reliable energy from the movement of waves. In the future, our homes could run on wave power. How can the sun light up our nights? Solar cells use the sun's rays to make electricity. They can be used for lights in the garden or in roof panels to power whole houses. Solar collectors use the sun's heat to warm water. If we cover the Sahara Desert with solar panels, it would make more electricity than the world could use. How is wind farmed? People have used wind power for many years. The first wind-powered machines were windmills. Now long blades spin at giant wind farms around the world. This type of farm can be built out at sea, too. Some power stations burn plant material, such as straw, willow, and elephant grass, to make electricity. Why say bye to flying? Airplanes give off huge amounts of carbon dioxide. To travel in a greener way, take vacations closer to home instead of flying. If you have to fly, try and get a direct flight because taking off and landing use the most energy. What are food miles? If something you eat comes from another country, it traveled many food miles to get to you, and lots of carbon dioxide was produced on the way. Buying food locally is often better for the environment. Why all the fuss about taking a bus? Traveling by bus or train does less damage to the environment than going by car, because many people share the energy used. If people share a car, they use less energy. Some roads have carpool lanes for cars carrying more than one person. Cycling and walking are much better for the environment than using a car because they do not burn oil. Why is garbage such a waste? Most of our trash is burned or buried in massive garbage dumps called landfills. Rain can wash poisons from the garbage through the soil and pollute the water supply. Landfills also release nasty gases into the air. What are the three R's? Reduce, reuse, recycle. We should reduce what we throw away, reuse things as much as possible, and when we don't need them anymore, recycle rather than dump them. As much as 70% of our garbage could be recycled. Recycling one aluminum can saves enough energy to run a television for 3 hours. When is a worm my friend? Compost is an excellent way to reduce waste and help the garden. Put old leaves, plants, fruit and vegetable peelings, eggshells, and newspaper in a special bin outside. Worms and insects will turn it into soil for the garden. Cut up newspaper is perfect in a compost bin because it soaks up moisture. Then tiny animals will munch away and break it up. How can I have a greenhouse? A green home might have solar panels, solar collectors, and a wind turbine on the roof. Insulation would be fitted to keep the heat in. Outside, rainwater would be collected in a tank and kitchen waste put in a compost bin. Turn down the heating by a few degrees to save energy and cut the heating bills. You won't even notice a difference. When is off? Not off. Appliances left on standby rather than turned off use between 10 and 60% of the power they use when they are on. Turn off your television and computer monitor when you're not using them. It is estimated that appliances on standby use up 8% of all British power consumption in the home. Why are some light bulbs greedy? Most of the energy that goes into a standard light bulb is changed into heat, not light. Switching to low energy light bulbs, which use less power than normal light bulbs, saves both energy and money. How else can I save energy? Switch off lights when you can and try not to use too much hot water. When you have a shower or a bath or make a hot drink, use only as much water as you need. One energy-saving light bulb uses up to 80% less electricity than an ordinary light bulb, yet it will last up to 12 times longer. What did you guys think of the second part of the book? Did you learn anything new here? I always love to learn new things about renewable energy because I think that with renewable energy, we can really make a difference in climate change. So check out the activities below, and thanks so much for joining us for Storytime this week. Bye, guys! Thank you so much for watching Future Energy Systems video. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of our exciting content. Check out the links below to our website and learning page where you can find activities, learning extension, and more. You can also sign up on the website for notifications for future videos and interactive opportunities. There's so much to learn as we explore our energy future.